Hi everyone, welcome to the November studio vlog. I started off the month with a mixed media test. Next year I'm going to be introducing mixed media pet portraits, so this painting is one of the test runs I created in my watercolour sketchbook. For the painting you will see me working on in this video, I started off with several light washes of watercolour. The one you will see below on this same sketchbook page I made too dark, so I decided to continue with the top one instead. Here I am using coloured pencils to lay fine texture and detail over the light watercolour washes. I am gradually building up the detail in layers from light to dark. In related news, I will be changing the options available for pet portraits in oils from January 1st, 2022. I will only be offering one size, A4, and the price for an A4 portrait is being increased. If you would like a pet portrait painted in oils at one of the current prices, please get in touch before 1st of January 2022. I will leave a link to more information in the description below. I took another exciting step with my Opera Moth series in early November, as I started glazing colour over the underpainting for the Paris Opera House rooftop. It's always exciting to see that first colour layer and the details and characters immediately start to look more defined. This painting series is an ongoing project that I am working on over on my Twitch channel on Mondays and Tuesdays. It focuses on moths living and working in and around the Paris Opera House in the late 1880s. A character from my Victorian Animal Family exhibition is also making a reappearance here. You can see Mr. Tawny Frogmouth in this painting, still looking dapper. This painting is the first one I've done with this much background detail, so I am very keen to see how it progresses, but I am also taking extra time to get it just right. Also at this point, I would just like to give a quick update on the Glide Gear overhead camera rig. It's fantastic! It has made painting so much easier and the camera is no longer wobbling, which means the picture is not blurry at all. I have much more room to move about and to move the painting about and not feel like there is a camera arm constantly in the way in front of my face. I would definitely recommend the Glide Gear rig if you're looking for a setup to film or stream your art. I was very happy to wrap up this little purple resin jet plane pendant and send it off to its new home. I have a few left in different colours on the website currently, but I am moving away from using polymer clay and resin for my hand sculpted jewellery and designs. Once these resin pieces are gone, I will not be bringing them back, but there are exciting new products and designs coming in 2022. At the end of the first week in November, my new standing desk arrived. I was so excited to set this up and use it along with the Glide Gear camera rig. I had been having some back issues while streaming, and while the overhead camera rig helped right away, I knew that the ability to stand up and move around more freely while painting would help me even more. I am happy to say that my back pain has pretty much completely gone, so this new setup has been an absolute game changer for me. I feel so much better now. The new desk is also quite a bit brighter than my old one, so I can now fit the supplies I need onto it without everything falling off all the time. It was finally time to say goodbye to my faithful old art desk and swap over to my new standing desk. Here is how my cramped setup looked beforehand. here's the new desk in place. It's a perfect fit for the space. Try creating some die-cut Christmas cards this year, and I bought some lovely glossy inkjet cardstock. I reprinted last year's Patreon Christmas cards to test the new cardstock. They turned out super cute, but the cardstock didn't like being folded at all, so unfortunately I will only be able to use it for postcards. I also created the packaging for my Fruit Hoot stickers, and this turned out perfectly. I even created little stickers that look like washi tape with my logo to seal each package. I'm still working on my Wizard of Oz project on Thursdays on Twitch. If you haven't heard me talk about this before, I am slowly working my way through the story chapter by chapter, creating illustrations. When they are all done, I will be creating my own book version of The Wizard of Oz. I still have a long way to go, but I'm enjoying the process and I've learned a lot about watercolours in the meantime. Here I am adding texture and detail over the watercolours with my Prismacolor coloured pencils. I love how this looks and it really adds the final touch to the piece. I am currently looking into different products for my shop for 2022. One of the items I am interested in producing is handmade notepads. I had already done a test one of these a while back and they were cute but a little wonky. This time around, I had a book press to use during the gluing process and this helped a lot. Thank you. My husband helped me DIY a press with some leftover scrap wood from a bookshelf and some wing nuts and bolts. It works very well. Test run with the book press went well, so I decided to make a better prototype. I used the Cricut this time to cut out each sheet exactly square, as my cuts with a little hobby guillotine were not precise. My Cricut blade is getting a little blunt, so I had to cut the sheet twice. I did manage to hone the Cricut blade later on and it started cutting perfectly again, but for now you will see that I had to put the sheet back in and do a second pass on the cutting. Then I cut some chipboard to fit on the back of the paper sheets and clipped everything together. Lot of paper sheets along with the backing card all in the book press to keep everything nice and straight while I applied the glue. Glue pen with a spongy tip, which was very handy, but I had trouble with the glue going onto the front sheet of each pad. I tried to clean it up with a spare bit of paper and this worked fairly well, but it was not really good enough for me. Eventually I worked out this issue in a later test run, but that will be in the next studio vlog, so stay tuned for that update. I was so happy with these little notepads when the glue was all dry and I took them out of the book press for the first time. They are still ever so slightly wonky, but were so much better than my first effort. I forgot to mention, the design on these notepads is my drawing of the bucket fountain here in Cuba Street in Wellington. The buckets on the fountain are actually red, blue and yellow, but I went with a pastel colour scheme for my version. I was very happy to send a print of Mr. Wecker and a pack of the new Fruit Hoot stickers off to a new home as well in November. I had a lot of fun packaging this up, as I always do with any orders I receive through my online store. I even included one of the tiny notepads as a freebie extra. Then it was time to go back to the mixed media cat piece and complete it. At this stage of the painting, I was not entirely happy with how it was going, but I kept on with the process. I very carefully kept adding fur texture with the coloured pencils until I was happy with the amount of detail. Here is an edited time lapse of the process. I hope you enjoy seeing this piece come to life. Had to add the final details, some extra watercolour here and there, some final coloured pencil detail, and also some shiny highlights in the eyes with white gouache paint. Thank you. watching this vlog, and thank you very much also to my patrons for your support in 2021. As this video is going up at the end of the year, I hope you have all had a lovely holiday season, and I will be back in 2022 with more art, more fun, and I'm very excited to share it all with you. Goodbye, and Happy New Year, everyone!